Okay, so it's the back page now, and you've got a 8 by 7 3/4. This is going to be part of an insert into a pocket with your 7 1/2 by 7 3/4. So that is your insert. Then you have a 4 by 8 1/2. That is a flap. You've got two of those. No. 4 by 8 1/2. Why is the one smaller than the other? Let me just see. I'm going to use this one, but it should have been 4 by 8 1/2. It's marked 4 by 8 1/2, but it's not 4 by 8 1/2, but yours is. And then you've got a 5 by 9. This is going to be pocket. No, 5 by 9. It's going to be a pocket. And 4 1/2 by 8. You've got 2 4 1/2 by 8s, man. Yes. You should have 2 4 by 8 1/2 and 1 4 1/2 by 8, which is a flap. But I've got that now. 4 by 8 1/2, 4 1/2 by 8, 5 by 9, and 7 1/2 and 7 3/4, 8 by 7 3/4. So let's do the scoring. Your 8 by 7 3/4. Place the 8 to the top and score at 1/2 inch. 7 1/2 by 7 3/4, keep as is. You're going to stick those together to make your insert. 4 1/2 by 8, place the 4 1/2 to the top and score at 1/2 inch. Then you've got your 4 by 8 1/2, and you're going to place the 8 1/2 to the top and score at 1/2 inch, and the other one as well, 8 1/2 to the top and score at 1/2 inch. And then your 5 by 9, place the 9 to the top, score at 1/2 inch, turn once, score at 1/2 inch, and turn again and score at 1/2 inch. And we are going to fold it quickly. Fold and burnish. This is your pocket, and you're going to cut it where the lines meet and where the lines meet. Two flaps. Up and down. That is your 4 by 8.5 piece. And then you've got a flap that's going to the right. And then of course your insert. And I'm going to stick my insert down. I'm just going to put glue on the folded piece here. Here is my insert that goes into the pocket, my flap and my flap and my pocket. So let's get the album close by. And I'm going to place my pocket first, and that's to the right edge. Then my flap that is going to go onto the pocket on the right edge. I've placed it just 1/8 from the side, and this is going to go onto my pocket. I'm going to place my short one. You haven't got a shorter one, but my short one. It's a bit too big. What should it be? Okay, I'm going to make your pocket size a bit smaller. I'm going to make it 4.5 by 9 because I'm going to place my flap underneath my pocket now so that everything fits in here. Quickly going to do that while so your pocket is only going to be 4.5 inches, so it's going to be 4.5 by 9 and not 5. And then of course the other one needs to go. To the bottom here. And there we go. That's done, that's done. And that can go. You can close everything like that. And then place your insert in there. And have glue. Let's just sort out the glue. Right. There. So I'll put in my insert. I still have glue. You can place it like that and close it like that, but I just want to cover. I will see where my glue is. Yeah, so let's do the covering. I'm going to use let's just cut off this Yeah. To mark on my pocket, as this has got to go into my pocket, and once again it will be just about an half an inch larger than the piece that I need. So I'm going to place this here. I'm going to cut this whole piece off. That, and then I will just cut this, and this will slip into my pocket. Like that, I'm going to place glue. Slip it in there. And then I'm going to cover the pocket. That's going to go on. Oh man, what am I doing? To look for another piece that I can put on the edge here. May peace be your gift at Christmas and your blessing all year. Okay. So, I'm going to place my insert. In here. And just to show you I'm going to keep everything closed. I'm going to close and I'm going to place a magnet. See that this is in the center. And I'm going to place my magnet on my closure part and here. So I'm going to do that first before I cover my flap. Make sure this is straight and in the center. And maybe place your magnet right in the center of your flap and not to the side, because then it's going to be right on the edge of your okay, once again, sticky side up. And let loose. Press that on there. Oops. No. I moved my insert. It's not straight. And there we go. So we need to cover this piece. And I suppose this is still not going to work. Man, oh man. Okay, let's see. Oh, my screw. Do this for me again. Okay, let's see what we have left. I've got a red piece here that I can put on the flap. I've got this that I can put on the pocket. And I've got another piece like that. And I've got another piece like this. That's what I've got left. And then of course all my cut out pieces. Okay, let's see. I'm going to is this going to be big enough? Just for my piece here. Laat ek tog nou net reg meet. Nie die verkeerde goed meet. Going to need this cut off piece here, the main strip. I'm very quickly going to do this, the main strip. Which I need to place in here where I've oh, I did something there. Okay, no, that's fine. Okay, fine. I did something there already. Oh my goodness, okay. So, have I got it right now? Just a slither too big. I've got so many cut out pieces left, and but I need one there, and I need one on here. My insert, and then I will need, I don't want to put this here because I've already got that there. Maybe I must. I like this page. I really like this page. It was good. Okay, so let's see. again. I think I'm going to leave that one for photos. I need to put, okay, that's my insert, that's got to have photos on. And I'm going to have something on the top. Let's just see, what can I put here? A red piece maybe? Like that, I think. I just need to do the right marking. Oh my word. Okay, that one's got to go down now. Okay, so there we go. You can have photos, photos, photos. photos, and then your insert. Photos, and place it down like that. And then of course you have a lot of leftover cut out pieces. Let's just see what have I got here. I think I'm going to use the other piece here. I need a scissor. So let's do it quickly. I'm just going to place glue on the edge and then just around the edge here. Then I have a tuck space if I want to place a photo in there. So that's going to go like that. That's going to go like that. And there we go. So if I want to tuck a photo in here, it's easy. Just place the photo like that. And let's see, that one is a little bit big for there. But of course, you can place all your pieces that is left all over. Still got another rhino, which can become another tuck spot. And this can become a tuck spot here, on here. So I'm going to glue this piece here. There. So then I've got a square, and I will place that down. And there I have another tuck spot for another photo, like that. So we are done. You can use all your cut out pieces. And place stuff down everywhere. And you are done with your album, except of course for the photos. So, I hope you all have a very Merry Christmas. May you have peace and joy and love and laughter, and take lots of photos and place it in your album. So, there we go. Our album is done. I'm just going to raise my lion and place it on here, all over there. Raise it like that, maybe right there in the center, not sure yet, but I will show you when I'm done. But I hope you enjoyed doing this album with me, and I hope that your album comes out beautiful, and have a lovely day. Thank you. Bye.